everyone, and welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie. Today, we are getting back to frickin' normal. I know, it's been how many love videos since the last normal Banjo-Kazooie has appeared? Since this is the last time we will be going to Treasure Trove Cove, I figured that I would show off everything once again. And, yeah, after this, we will not be coming back because there are no more cheats after this. No more cheats, I'm not showing off wishy-washy Banjo, which would be happening at this level if Momo had not transformed me in Mad Monster Mansion. Or Mad Monster Manor. I've seen both names. I know it's Mad Monster Mansion, but whatever. Alright, so, crap gone, and first we're gonna put in the Gold Feathers cheat. This will double our gold feathers, just like the Red Feathers cheat doubled our red feathers, and the Blue Eggs cheat doubled our blue eggs. So yeah, there's that. Come on. I forgot to hit the D. Wow. I am on a roll today. And two more. Need the S. Okay, the E and the S. Whatever. Okay, I usually don't go back and watch what Gruntilda says, but oh my god, that was a lame rhyme. Seriously, that is pathetic. So yes, now we have 20 gold feathers, and we are back to normal. Today, well, we only have one more. Wow, speaking, what's that? Alright. So, yeah, we are going off to do... Wow, my brain is just completely gone at the moment. That's what I get for watching Tobuscus videos. Hi-ho! But yes, we are going to go unlock Click Clock Woods, which we have to run all the way to Click Clock Woods in order to unlock it. This is the last time we will be seeing these areas right here. I could do a retrospective right about here, but... By the way, we're almost done with this Let's Play, just like we're almost done with Metal Arms, A Glitch in the System. In fact, we should be done by this month. After these videos, I'm going to have an update video come up, kind of give you an idea of what games I'm planning on Let's Playing, planning on doing. Not 100% sure about what's what at the moment, but yeah. So, now we're getting to a new area. Well, not new-ish. There's a Mumbo token up there. I'm pretty sure we can't get that until we do something else. Why am I going this way? I'm not going back to get the notes, am I? No. No. Alright, so. Now, let us go unlock that note door and move on. Yep. 640. Not too bad. You can get that easy enough. Here we got a lot of will-o-wisps. That's not what they're called. Whiplashes. There we go. These tendril-esque things. Hey! Right. By the way, you cannot kill the bull. In fact, if you run into it with the Wonder Wing, as you saw right there, he pretty much just falls down and then you jump backwards for some particular reason. We could go on to the next area right now, but I'd feel bad if we didn't visit Click Clock Woods. Because it is actually a well-designed level for all the flaws that I'm going to point out in it. But, regardless. In order to open up Click Clock Woods, one must first hit that switchback there. And this is the reason these pots exist. These cauldrons are literally to make it easier for you going to one place than the other. Going from Click Clock Woods' main entrance to Click Clock Woods' puzzle. Now, interesting story. The first time I saw this, I knew for a fact that that was a world opener, but I had no clue where the puzzle piece was that was supposed to unlock it. It took me years to figure this out. Years. I'm not kidding. Hey, bro. As always, Gruntilda, disgusting, and stop pointing out that I'm hurt! Regardless, this is the puzzle. There's only one piece filled in. Bada bing, bada boom. There we go. All of the puzzle pieces. Now you don't have to collect all the notes and all the jiggies from every world to unlock everything in the game. Well, okay, you have to collect all the jiggies in the game, which means that on my first file, I never, ever, ever managed to get all of them because of that one jiggy and Rusty Bucket Bay. Why am I going to Treasure Trove Cove? Oh, that was weird. Anyway, the truth is, you only have to collect 98 notes from every world in order to open all the note doors. And I think you can get all but two jiggies in order to, it's two or four. You can get all but two or four jiggies, to access all the, puzzles. All the puzzle pictures in the, whole game. So, you don't have to 100% run this in order to, get what you want. Oh, I see. I see. The gorilla's your friend. However, I'm your enemy. Racist. You're a racist! Anyway, let's get on to the level. This is Click Clock Woods. It's kind of an interesting little time-esque level. There are four different variations of the map that are in this, but really you only have one level that you have to redo four times. That's a little annoying, especially when you're trying to find all the notes. Which, spoilers, I'm going to have to come back and collect all 100 notes again. Because, surprise, surprise, I kicked the bucket, and I don't have enough to access the one power-up in the entire game I actually need. But, you're gonna use a lot of bone feathers in these levels because of all these, fly trap things. You don't necessarily have to do it for the, first one right there. Well, you don't have to do it for this first area. You have a, mumbo transformation that gets you here. You have a mumbo transformation that allows you to sit on top of the flowers without, Wonder Wing being activated. Now, for those of you who know this game, you'll know that there's a DK reference coming up. That's right! That is Naughty from the Donkey Kong Country games. Naughty being one of the most basic enemies that you can find in Donkey Kong Country. Now, one thing I do have to say about those stupid bear trap flowers is the fact that, it really annoys me that it takes two feathers in order to actually activate them, and I'm retarded there. We'll come back to that, don't worry, I just can't remember at the moment, what I'm supposed to do. I'll look it up on game FAQ for a second. Anyway, these are the basic and most annoying enemies in the game. Not because of that, though. I said game, I meant this level. I'm making all kinds of mistakes in today's commentary. But, the reason they are is because they're exactly like those slug things and the bone slugs that are... Oh, God! They're like the bone slugs and the slugs you saw in earlier levels, the things that pop out of the walls. They have the exact same pattern. The only difference is their hitbox is different enough that it'll throw you off. You can actually roll beyond these guys, and you can beak barge beyond them, but you can't actually... Your timing has to be impeccable in order to, kill these things. The best way I can suggest is to use the beak barrage, the jump and then hit B attack. And an hour and a half later, I'm back. Okay, so yes, the brambles do hurt you, just if you're curious. And for the last level, you do actually have a Mumbo transformation. And I have to say, this is probably the best Mumbo transformation in the game. It got a major upgrade in Banjo-Kazooie, but this is probably the best one here, because it actually does something that the others don't. And I'll get into that once Mumbo decides to actually change us. Now, yes, I do have a problem with the bee. It has the same flaw as all of the other transformations besides the crocodile, in the fact that it has no offensive capabilities. However, I do have to admit that it is pretty cool that it has the ability to fly without expending any feathers, which is probably the most awesome thing in the game, to be completely honest. But, as you see, we are not the only bee in Click Clock Woods, amazingly. Yes, these Zubbas, again, returning enemies in Banjo-Tooie, as we will get to next time we get to a Banjo-Kazooie game. But as you saw, there was a purple Jinjo in the beehive. Again, I'm going to say that I don't particularly enjoy this level, but it is an interesting concept. Showing what a forest goes through during the four seasons. As you see, the summer dial is right there, and we get introduced to a character. I say a character, not use his name, because I honestly don't remember what it is, and he's not that important until fall. Right now, we're just watching him eat nuts in the, next... season, we see him being fat. In the third season, he actually gives us a jiggin. In the fourth season, he's sleeping in bed with a pink squirrel. No, I don't know how that works. Anyway, all the way up here at the top, you want to fly up as a bee. It allows you to grab onto this... Ah, crap, I thought it was going to fall. Green Jinjo that's on this bear trap right here. Yes, that's actually what they're called for any of you wondering. I've said it twice now. There's one more thing that we could do with the bee, but I can't remember what it is at the moment. So we'll be coming back to this probably a little later. So how are you all doing today? I'm doing fantastic, but the bald-faced fly I hate today. I've been so busy, and I'm not done yet. My dad's birthday is in 2 days. I'm working on a video project for him. I've just got so much crap I gotta do still. I need to prepare for this, but I think he should like his present. But I'm also in charge of party planning. I'm in charge of cleaning my house. Today is not fun. But get why I talked about it while I was a bee, because I'm just busy as a bee. That joke was terrible. Anyway, back to Banjo and Kazooie, because we have to make our way up the tree as well, Banjo and Kazooie. And yes, as the game mentioned, the Brambles hurt you. That is also the last Mumbo transformation in the entire game. So we have no need for any more Mumbo tokens other than just a collect-a-thon, which we don't want in the first place. But let's make our way up the tree, shall we? By the way, these parrots aren't that annoying at the moment, but wait for it, they get worse. Okay, so, most of the way you're gonna want a talent trot. There are a dozen or so extra lives in this level, so it's not that bad. And that's why these bird things are annoying. This is a completely vertical level, and these enemies knock you off the platforms. Am I playing an NES game? But as I said, just jump up with the garage and slam them straight in the eye sockets, and you should be fine. The beehive isn't really important until summer, so we'll be coming back to that once we move on to the next area. But first, we have to climb up all the way to the tree to access that panel. And did I mention that it is incredibly likely that you will fall to your death in this level? I like this level, kind of. I like the idea behind this level, but the execution just sucks. If I had to pick a second least favorite level... Let me rephrase. If I had to pick a least favorite level, it'd be Rusty Bucket Bang, but this comes as a close second. Fire's Cavern is definitely my third least favorite level, just because of all of the water you have to go through. Constantly being hit by enemies, it's just annoying. But anyway, we have one thing that we have to do before we move on to the top of the tree and get the jiggy that's up there. We have to free this egg from, well, we have to free the thing inside the egg. If you notice, this is the same graphic that they used for the egg in the Mama. And one phone call later, I'm back. Alright, the only thing left in this video is working our way up to the tree. There's a Mumbo token and a few... Oh, no, that's in the winter level, my bad. Alright, I will see you guys next time on Let's Play Banjo-Kazooie. And we will be getting more stuff done. Alright, I am ShadeGrey and I have been your humble narrator for this evening. And I will see you next time. Later!